Question 17, we're going to use composition of functions to determine whether two functions are inverses of each other. What an inverse is, it means a one function that undoes what the other function does. And so, subtraction and addition are inverses of each other. Multiplication and division are inverses. So this first one, A, looks very promising. One you're subtracting 3, the other you're adding 3. Those are inverse operations. The way we go about using composition to prove that is we take a composition of one function into the other. So we do F composite G, and then we do G composite F. We end up where we started, and where do we start? We start at X. Then it is a inverse. In both cases, we have to end up back at X. Not negative X, not 3x, not x plus 2, not 1, but x. We have to end up back at x. So for this first one, we're going to do this first part, f composite g. So f is the outside function. So if we do f composite g of x, we take the f function, x minus 3, and we rewrite it as parentheses, so that's x minus 3. In that parentheses, we put the g function, x plus 3, and then now we simplify. So these parentheses, there is no exponent up here, there's no multiplication in the front, there's no negative. We can remove the parentheses and we just have x plus 3 minus 3. Order of operations, we can combine like terms, plus 3 and minus 3 is 0. So this ends up being just x. So the first composition shows that f composite g of x is x. We got back to where we started. We started at x, we ended up at x. Now we do the test to see if g of f of x works. And yes, you're probably thinking it will work just fine, and it will. So g of f of x. So we're going to take the g function, and that's going to be our outside function. So x plus 3, so we do parentheses plus 3. So this is x plus 3. In that parentheses, we're going to put the f function, x minus 3. Just like last time, there's no exponent, there's no number in front. We can remove the parentheses. That gives us x minus 3 plus 3. We can combine the like terms. Negative 3 plus 3 is 0. Our final answer is x. We started at x, we ended up at x. So these are inverse functions of each other. So we'll just click that. Back. And so the B part, now you might say, well, they're the same function. This is minus 1 over 2x and this is 1 over 2x. So again, we're going to do the same thing, but with these functions. So we're going to start with f of g of x. So we're going to plug in g of x into f of x. And the thing is if this first one isn't equal to x, we're done. We can say they're not inverses. But if this is equal to x, we have to test the second one. So we start off with the outside function. So we're plugging f of g of x. Right. F is going to be minus 1 over 2x. Okay. And into that space, we're going to plug in 1 over 2x. And now we just need to simplify. So we can think of this as going to be minus 1 over, in the denominator, we can just take the 2 times, think of this as 2 over 1. So we get 2 over 2x. So 2 divided by 2 is 1. So that ends up with really just 1 over x. So what we're left with is negative, we're going to have 1 in the numerator, a fraction we could think of as division, divided by 1 over x. Remember, when you divide by a fraction, you invert and multiply, so this becomes 1 times x over 1, or just x, and this becomes negative 1 times x. We end up with negative x. But we didn't start with negative x, we started with positive x. So this is not an inverse. We ended up at negative x. Nope, that's not right. This probably would have worked as long as this wasn't negative, but it is negative, so for this one, we just have to say, we don't even have to check the second one, just say that f and g are not inverses of each other. That's because negative x is not x. Okay, that's it. Just a quick follow-up to 17, I'll tack this on. I forgot there's these, we're supposed to answer here. I erased all my work, but remember this was x, this was x, this was negative x. And I guess since they want to know what this is, we have to go through it. You could see that we would get the same thing, except when we plug in this, we get the negative from the f of x. We're gonna get the same value. So I'm going to call that negative x, but I'll leave that up to you to do the second composition. But you'll see you'll get the same thing. All right, thank you.